this the whole Christmas season. Now please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. Or it could be perhaps that his shoes were too tight. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. There's hanging their stockings, he snarled with a sneer. Tomorrow's Christmas, it's practically here. Then he growled with his crunched fingers, nervously drumming. I must find a way to stop Christmas from coming. For tomorrow, he knew. All the wee girls and boys awake bright and early. They rushed for their toys, and then, oh, the noise. That's the one thing he hated, the noise.
Bags that the Grinch very nimbly sucked all the bags up one by one.
drop to dump it. They're waking up now. I know just what I'll do. Their mouths will hang open a minute or two. And then the who's gonna move them all cry. Well, that's a noise from the Grinch I simply must hear. So he paused, and the Grinch put a hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, and started to grow. The sound wasn't sad. Why, the sound sounded merry. It couldn't be so. It was merry, merry. He stared down at the well with Grinch out of his eyes. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came. Somehow or other, it came just the same.